Welcome to Life Devotions, and thank you for joining me today. The Divine Nature is the title of this devotion. Of course, we read about that in 2 Peter chapter 1, where it talks about us having become partakers of the divine nature. And I share this with you today, not just to give you another thing to listen to, but to really press upon your heart something that is really the only answer for any of us. You know, false religion, somebody said, always demands efforts of its inheritors, or the people that yield to it, to obtain the kind of promises they give. But within Christianity, it is all in Christ and by His Spirit that we experience transformation in our lives, so that none of us can boast. God has made Jesus unto us wisdom, righteousness, justification, sanctification, and redemption, so that as it is written, he who boasts, let him boast in the Lord. It is so essential that we realize where the answer lies on a daily basis for our own walk in this life, and often struggle with our human nature. Because sometimes we can all have feelings that we feel, oh, I'll never change, or there's no answer for me, or they'll never change, you know, might as well give up on them. No, friends, if you realize that the power that God gives us in Christ is more than sufficient, then it gives us faith that God is able to work what is impossible with man. Even Peter said to Jesus in Mark chapter 10, but then, Lord, how can anyone be saved? And Jesus said, that is impossible with man. But what is impossible with man is possible with God. And you see, God is able to work a transformation by granting us to become partakers of His divine nature. So let me read you here from 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 1. Simon Peter, a bondservant and apostle of Jesus Christ, to those who have obtained like precious faith with us by the righteousness of our God and Savior Jesus Christ, grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of our Lord Jesus Christ, as His divine power has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of Him who called us by glory and virtue, by which have been given to us exceedingly great and precious promises, that through these you may be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that's in the world through lust. Oh, the wonder of seeing the promises of God come to pass in your own life. I mean, things that others desire, Jesus said to his disciples who were beginning to experience the life that he gives. He said, what you are hearing and seeing, kings and prophets desired to hear and see and did not. But to you it's been given to know the mystery of the kingdom, the mystery of God's dominion and rule within us. Something they heard about, something they prayed about and sought, but they knew when they spoke about this, Peter says, they were speaking to us for what God would give us. My goodness, what we now have through Jesus Christ to be able to share in the inheritance of the saints in the light, to become partakers of the divine nature, to begin to experience within ourselves His goodness, His glory, His nature, His character. Wow. I mean, it's beyond measure. It's beyond measure. And if we do not hear about it, then we will not know about it, and we will not have faith for it. But if we hear about these things, then we will come to know what has been freely given to us in Christ Jesus. And we begin to have the kind of faith that Peter talks about here for all of us who have obtained like precious faith. Oh, the faith that he was living in to share the nature and character and glory and goodness of Jesus Christ, by which he was completely free from that evil corruption that caused him to fail so bitterly when he denied the Lord Jesus. Oh my goodness, dear friends, the Lord is so rich in his loving kindness and tender mercies towards us all. I am so grateful to have this faith that I now share the nature and character and goodness and glory of Jesus being manifest in me by the Holy Spirit. I mean, what should you look for, you may ask? What should you look for? Well, let's start right at the top, shall we? Go with me to Matthew 17, okay? What should I look for, Pastor? What should be my expectation in sharing this divine nature? Yes, live free from the corruption that's in the world through lust. Amen. But that is the negative side. Negative as in that corruption of lust is the negative side. To be free from that is one thing. That's like saying to Israel, you're coming out of Egypt. That's the negative side. Living in Egypt is the negative side. But they did not come out for the sake of coming out. They came out for the sake of entering in. We come out of the lust of this world to enter into the divine nature and to share the glory that the Father has given his Son Jesus, that we may share the glory that he has given Jesus. Very important thought. What is that glory? Look at it right here in Matthew 17, verse 2. And he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as the light. In Luke chapter 9, it says, white as snow, brilliant white. He was transfigured before them. God was made manifest in the flesh, for it pleased the Father that in him the fullness should dwell, that the fullness of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit should be made manifest in the body of Jesus, you and I now, because we now share his glory, also partake of that glory in the knowledge of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You say, oh, come on, come on, come on, Pastor. That is going to happen maybe when we go to heaven. No, that's for here, for right now. Look what it says here in chapter 2 of Colossians. For in him dwells all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and you are complete in him, who is the head of all principality and power. You are complete in him. You share through Jesus in his glory. Oh my goodness, what amazing grace. Stephen was somebody, look at Acts chapter 6, who lived in this. And I mean, I love Stephen. He was just a deacon. He was a servant. That's what deacon means, servant. He served the tables. He took care of the widows, of the Greek widows who didn't have any provision. He brought them food and took care of them and helped them sort out their issues and troubles. And he was just somebody who was willing to work hard. But it says in verse 8 of Acts 6, Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and signs among the people. Verse 10, they were not able to resist the wisdom and the spirit by which he spoke. Verse 15, and all who sat in the council, looking steadily at Stephen, saw his face as the face of an angel. So you see that the glory of Christ was radiant from his earthen vessel. What do you expect? Oh, I live for this every day. I live for this because I bear, according to 2 Corinthians 4, verse 6, this treasure of Christ. He is the treasure of God. I bear this treasure in the earthen vessel. I am the body of Christ, the temple of his Holy Spirit, and so are you. And I have this treasure in this earthen vessel. Why? Am I ever not going to be an earthen vessel? Oh, no, I'm going to be an earthen vessel for eternity. Yes, I will have a renewed body, but it will still be an earthen vessel. Why? Why? So that the glory and the excellence of the power may be of God and not ourselves. My goodness, friends, I wouldn't want it any other way. I would never want it of myself. But the wonder about being the vessel of the treasure is that the the vessel itself takes on the nature and character and glory of the treasure. Christ is the treasure in the earthen vessel. The vessel itself takes on the nature and character and glory of the treasure, but it's the treasure that causes the vessel to have its substance. Oh, I feel the anointing of Jesus in me as I'm talking to you right now. Because so many times we look at the vessel and feel poor. But I want to encourage you to look at the treasure, look at Christ, and feel rich. Let the poor say, I'm rich, the scripture says. Oh, God would have us live in such a phenomenal way that we realize that what we have in Jesus Christ is this treasure. I mean, look what it says in Acts chapter 4. It says in verse 13, and when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were uneducated and untrained men, because they just happened to be fishermen. Not that all fishermen aren't smart. They marveled and realized that they had been with Jesus. Look at chapter 5, verse 14, right? They had been with Jesus. Verse 14. And the believers were increasingly added, this verse 14 of chapter 5 of Acts, multitudes of both men and women, so that they brought the sick out into the streets, laid them on beds and couches, that at least the shadow of Peter passing by might fall on some of them. Also, a multitude gathered from the surrounding cities to Jerusalem, bringing sick people and those who were tormented by unclean spirits, and they were all healed. What are you looking for in your life? This is what I'm looking for. When I think about being a partaker of the divine nature of Christ, I'm not just thinking about living free from the corruption that's in the world through lust. Sure, I do. Sure, I do. It's like when you take a bath or a shower, what do you do that for? Sure, to wash off the dirt, the sweat, the smell. Sure. But you're not just thinking about getting rid of the smell and the dirt. You're thinking about living clean, living pure, living, smelling well, and being happy in that cleanliness. Oh, I love taking a bath before I go to bed in the evening. I love it. I tell you, I take a bath. Why? Because I love living in the bed and being clean. Oh, my goodness, I wouldn't want to smell up the sheets. And no, I like to be clean. You see, the same is true, that we're not just thinking about living free from the lust that's in the world through lust, and therefore partaking of the divine nature. No, that we may share His glory, His character in nature. That's the clean part, the positive part. Yes, living free from the lust that's in the world is important, but what is much more important is that we partake of His divine character, His divine nature, His goodness, His kindness, His love, His generosity, His willingness, His humility, His gentleness, His forbearance, His goodness, His long-sufferance, His upright, well-pleasing spirit before the Father. And the list is endless of the riches of the glory of His grace we are granted to share now that we have become a partaker of His divine nature. Wow. Wow. And Paul says in Galatians 3, verse 8, I, who am the least of all the saints, this grace has been given to make known the riches of the glory of His grace. Don't ever look down on yourself. Don't ever compare yourself. Refuse to. I will not do it. I will not compare myself to any man. I will honor every man. I will respect them, appreciate them, be kind and gracious and support them and help them, but I will not compare myself. I will not do it because I think it's sin to do that. Why? I've not been made in the likeness of another man. I've been made in the likeness of my Father. I partake of His divine nature, and my joy is to share that nature with others in the kindness, in the grace, in the goodness, in the love, in the forbearance, in the patience, in the humility, and in the generosity. Do you hear it? And this is what the Holy Spirit's giving you today. Be encouraged, friends. If you feel poor in your earthen vessel, know the treasure is within you. It will never fail to be there for you. And you who are poor, you are rich. So be encouraged. Have a good day.